The use of open educational resources, or OER as they are referred to in short, is a new approach to learning that has been taken up at all levels of the education sector, allowing teaching and learning materials to be created and then used and reused by anyone with internet access. OER sites such as oercommons.org give limited or unrestricted licensing rights through a Creative Commons license, part of a growing movement to encourage and foster reuse of what would be otherwise copyrighted works. At the university level, MIT now release almost all of its course material openly through its MIT Open Courseware site. Almost anyone can now access MIT lecture notes, exam papers and videos. This initiative has arguably boosted people's awareness of the university, raising the profile of several contributors and undoubtedly increasing the overall impact of MIT and some of their key academics. Here at Oxford, many academics have released related podcasts and videos as OER as part of the Open Spires initiative. More specifically within politics, the blogging site Politics Inspires, www.politicsinspires.org, adopts the principles of OER as well. Using OER is as simple as uploading a file. Jorum is the nationally funded e-learning repository for the UK and can be used by any UK academic. Videos, for example, could be uploaded to YouTube, lectures or podcasts can be uploaded through iTunes U, and lecture notes could be placed into something like SlideShare. All of these sites provide innovative systems for distributing educational content. There is every chance someone you know is already doing this, and these sites, such as YouTube or Jorum, have people employed to help you with any problems that you may face. And they're very popular. Some academic channels on YouTube are more popular than those of Premiership football clubs. You may have seen Martin Polyakov's YouTube pages. His YouTube channel, The Periodic Videos, has a small YouTube video for every element in the periodic table. Other users of YouTube have won their authors prestigious awards such as the Times Higher Educational Leadership Management Award, and so offer distinct scope to increase what people now refer to as impact. There are other sites you can also go to, such as Expert, and there are other places where you may find OER that you can use or a good place to put content so it can be discovered. There are arguments that releasing the materials for free denigrates the value of educational resources, but for those who are seeking new ways of finding out about impact, choosing to use OER and publishing research to open journals, these are similar ways to push out the value of your work and increase the awareness of these things. You may also find that there are other benefits in OER, including increasing your profile, your department or your institution, outreach to the general public and contributing to education worldwide, and finally, as a way of attracting students to your course.